Welcome all for the video tutorial on machine learning. Today we'll start with the third module, which is about artificial neural networks. The content of our third module is, the first session will be about the introduction to ANN, followed by neural network representation. Then we'll discuss about the appropriate problems for neural network learning, followed by perceptron, and finally the backpropagation algorithm. What is artificial neural network? It is nothing but a model which is going to implement an artificial intelligence over it. What is artificial intelligence? Here in artificial intelligence, we are making a machine to think like that of a human being. So we are going to implement a thinking mechanism in a machine. So when you give an input, the machine has to think over the given input and it has to produce the output. This is what an artificial neural network is, and we implement this in for learning real value data, discrete value data, and our vector value datas. What is the motivation behind this artificial neural network is? Yes, it is the biological neural network which motivated for the emergence of an artificial neural network. When the thinking capacity of human is analyzed, we can implement the same thing over a machine. How do a human think? He thinks with the help of brain. It is a task of a brain to take over these activities, and we know we have billions and trillions of neurons in our brain, and these neurons work collaboratively to produce an output. That what is the output here? To carry out a task. For example, when we see a fire, what happens? What is the input signal given to the brain? When we visualize a fire, the input is given by the eyes to the neurons. What that neurons does, it is going to stimulate the other neuron which is associated with the sense of touch. So it triggers and it gives the message not to touch that. Okay, so what happens here? Input signal is given to the neuron and neuron gives the output, and it gives you the warning that not to touch the fire. Similarly, even your artificial neural network works. When you give an input, your machine thinks over that input and it is going to give you the output. The output may be either it may be your output will be based upon the application what we use. First, we'll analyze how a biological neural network works. Example, consider a baby. When a baby is born, it doesn't know anything. It doesn't know anything, and it starts learning by analyzing the data. What happens? It visualizes the data and it gets trained and it starts learning to do the activity. How does a baby walk? It first visualizes, it collects the input, and it trains itself and it learns from it and it starts walking. Okay, here we'll see one example. When a man is given with the two food item where he is not aware of the taste of the both the items. Okay, so we give two food items here. One is the broccoli, the other one is the candy. When the man has not tasted it, he doesn't know what is the feature it possesses. Okay, so initially he doesn't know anything about it, so he is going to train the neurons in the brain so that when next time when both the items has been given, the neurons in the brain can choose over the food item. So initially we assign a weight. I weight to the both the food items. What is weight? Weight is nothing but the features, the importance of the feature. Okay, so the importance of a feature we give it as a weight. The more important feature, we assign more weight. And when a feature is of less importance, we assign a less weight. Initially, I doesn't know which is broccoli or which is candy. So I give the equal importance to that. So initially, I assign the weight as 100 for both the food items. So now what I do, I taste both the food items. At first, I taste the broccoli and my neurons in the brain starts learning. So, it starts learning the taste of the broccoli. Okay, so now what happens? After tasting, I came to know it is not so tastier. Okay, so I assign a weight. I change my weight with that learned experience. I have tasted the food item, but that doesn't give me a taste, a sense of taste. Okay, so what I do? I reduce my weight. Okay, first I have initially have assigned the weight as 100. Since I am not comfortable with the taste here, I reduce my weight to 1. Okay, so what happens? What my neurons in the brain predicts here? Broccoli is not going to taste, so I am not going to go with the broccoli when next time the same food item is offered. So next I am tasting the candy. When I taste the candy, I come to know that candy tastes better than the broccoli. So what I choose, what I prefer candy than the broccoli. So the weight what I have assigned for candy remains the same. Initially I doesn't know the taste of both the food items, so initially I assign the equal weightage after training my neurons. Now how my neurons in the brain has trained? It has trained with both the broccoli and the candy. So my neuron know what is the taste of the broccoli now and what is the taste of the candy. So when the next time both the food items are given, my brain can go with the candy. Okay. What, how this mechanism is studied in the brain? So you are training your neurons with both the food items, and it gets trained with the features of the food items what has been provided. It know what is the feature of a broccoli is. It is not going to, it may be a bitter taste, and it is, or it may not taste as sweeter as that of candy. So my neurons in the brain learn the features of it. So again, it has learned what all the features I have with the candy. So now my neurons in the brain does the comparative study over both the food items, and it is going to probably choose candy when the next time both the items are given. Okay, so what is the mechanism followed here? You're going to train your neurons with set of data, and with that trained data, it is going with the prediction. Here, we are going to train the, here initially you have assigned the equal weightage for both the candy and broccoli. After your neurons are trained, you are going to reduce the weightage of your broccoli. So whenever next time when both the items are given, your neurons in the brain can go with the prediction. Yes or no, or the food item to choose among both. Okay, this is how your biological neural network works, and we are going to implement the same principle over the machine. Even in the machine, you are going to train the machine with the data sets. So whenever the next time when you give an input to the machine, it is going to compare that input with the data which has been already trained, and it is going to give you the final output. Either it may be of a prediction or it may be of a classification. The same working principle of biological neural network is implemented here even in an artificial neural network. So what we do here, we give a set of input, and from that input, your machine is going to learn few features, and from that learned feature, it is going to predict the output. This is how your artificial neural network works. See, here we are given an example of an artificial neural network. We have input values x1, x2 up to xm, or all the input values we give to the machine. Okay, and we have a features for all the input, and all the features will be assigned and weightage. Okay, so for x1 the weightage assigned is w1, and for x2 the weightage assigned is w2, and xm the weight assigned is wm. So now what you're going to do here is, now we are going to implement some mathematical function over the input data. Okay, with this input data, we are applying a mathematical function. We have an summation function and an activation function, and through which we predict the output. The working principle will be explained in the next session. This is how your artificial neural network works. Okay, it is similar to a biological neural network. We give an input here. That input will be given to the next layer, or with where your machine has already been trained there, and finally you get an output from that. This is how your ANN is. This is all about the introduction about the ANN. Thank you all.